everything leaks in India. Whether it's the petrol tank of the old scooter, or it is a medical test which is leaked out to the public. But in this case, for the first time we have a news report that says that an army paper has been leaked out, and among the 18 arrested is an ex-serviceman. The exam has been cancelled. This is not the first time that a recruitment board exam has been cancelled in India. There have been allegations against every recruitment board, whether it's medical services, or it's the Public Service Commission, or it's the State Public Service Commission, or there have been large-scale recruitments by thousands of policemen and police officials in the state of Uttar Pradesh or any other state, or the Vyapam scam in Madhya Pradesh, that there have been allegations that papers have been leaked out and people have been helped in doing mass copying. The system of education, from toppers in Bihar to toppers in various medical universities, etc., 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 you can name them, has come under fire many times. Obviously, all chairmen of all recruitment boards and the government of India and the states need to do a major rethink on how they are planning to recruit officers and staff to the government. Also, now that the army is in the loop, the army also has to rethink how to do this system so that it becomes foolproof, there is no scope for corruption in it, and there is no scope for leaks in it either. Which means that the papers have to be designed very differently, the questions have to be put very differently, and the system of rote learning has to be set aside, which encourages the design of papers which can be then leaked out to candidates. Despite all these rigorous measures, provisions, various recruitment boards, we still end up recruiting thousands, hundreds of corrupt, indolent officials who make news almost every day. Some of them are going to jail, some of them are being arrested for graft, some of them are leaking out papers, some of them are manipulating recruitments in their states. This situation is indeed a very sorry situation for India. The worst part is that even after going to jail, these people are socially acceptable because of the large illegal amount of money they have amassed. A very sorry state of affairs for Indian society.